Hello, I'm Mari Mizutani from Keio University.
Hello, I am Motohiko Kato from Keio University.
We are very happy to introduce our recent study entitled Predictors of Technical Difficulty for Complete Closure of Causal Defects After Duodenal Endoscopic Resection.
First of all, why did you decide to conduct this study?
We reported that the prophylactic closure of mucosal defects after duodenal endoscopic resection can reduce delayed adverse events. So we closed the mucosal defects after ER regardless of intraprocedural perforation. We also reported even a large mucosal defect after ESD can be closed completely by string clip suturing technique. However, it isn't always easy. Under certain circumstances, it can be technically challenging. It is clinically important to prepare for these difficult cases, and we conduct this study was to identify the predictors of difficulty during the complete closure of mucosal defects after duodenal ER.
Please explain the design of the study.
This is the single-center retrospective observational survey. The patients who underwent duodenal ER between July 2010 and May 2020 were enrolled. We reviewed the endoscopic images and analyzed the relationships between the degree of closure or closure time and clinical features of the lesions using univariate and multivariate analysis.
How many cases were included of the study?
A total of 954 lesions were treated by ER during the study period at our facility. Of these, we excluded lesions treated with cold polypectomy, lesions were left unclosed intentionally, and lesions involved papilla or further. Finally, 698 lesions were included in the analysis.
Or many cases. What was the main outcomes of the study?
Lesion location in the medial or anterior wall and lesion size affected the incomplete closure of mucosal defects after duodenal ER. Treatment period, treatment with ESD, a large lesion size, an occupied circumference over one half, and intraoperative perforation affected closure time.
So, is there a difference between the predictors of incomplete closure and the predictor of taking a long time to close?
Yes, that's an important point of this study. Lesion location in the medial anterior wall was an independent predictor of an increased risk of incomplete closure. There are two reasons. One is the lesion and the working channel are in opposite sides, and another is the thread interval with endoscope. A large lesion size, particularly in the wrong axis direction, the end of the mucosal defect could not be approximated, even when we use the string clip suturing method. Lesions with other factors can be closed completely even if taking a long time.
Finally, how can this research be applied to clinical field?
If the lesion has these predictors, we need to prepare for the treatment beforehand. For example, we need to set a longer prospective procedure time or refer to the expert doctor for doing procedure. Please read the entire paper on the internet or journal. Thank you.